Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynet and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. We're still in the Eclipse camp over here. And I'm gonna need to use double precision arrows for these guys. There we go, because that kills them in one hit. So I need to be careful that I use two. And there are only a few more guys left in this camp, apparently. I think there's only one left. The one over there.
Dig sites. They're massive.
Ooh, that was almost next to the pole, but there we go. I think this is everybody over here, so I'm just going to take a look around. Because indeed, Odin has been warning us about a bigger corruptor, so a Deathbringer, I think he called it. And it seems like they have been finding them over here. Which is, of course, not good for us, because that means we're going to have to fight one of those things really, really soon. Hello. There's more stuff up here, probably just the guys I killed. Okay. Feels like we found pretty much everything, which means we're going to head deeper into the camp. Because I think the game wanted us to come in from over here next to the supply cache. And now we need to head further, so what else are we gonna find? I think, yeah, I only have one health potion. Maybe I should do something about that. Craft potions, a full health potion. Let's make two of those.
I can always use these.
Indeed. Thank you, Aloy. Getting the words right out of my mouth. So I know there's a few things over there. Apparently it stopped marking them for me. Oh, shit. There's a guy in here. Just gonna whistle at that guy.
Hearing things?
Yeah, you're hearing things. You're hearing the sound of your impending death.
Oh, no.
There we go. There we go. So there's a corruptor. Multiple watchers. A lot of watchers, actually. Jesus Christ, there's a lot of dudes in here. Maybe I should drop down? Do I have any stealth around here? Seems like there's grass up here. Ooh-ah. Please don't get spotted by anything else, because there's another watcher over there, yeah. And then one over there as well. Aha! There we go. I got him on the lure. Oh, if only they would walk a bit faster.
Come.
No. Yeah, indeed. Over here. And also funny that that lure attack only lures one of these guys. Goodbye. Okay. Thanks for that. And thanks for that. So now I need to slowly take out everything else. The watchers first would be ideal. Especially if I can lure them over here. There we go. And then lure the watcher over here. Watch out for the rat. Yeah, he doesn't care about the rat. Ooh, there's somebody watching for me, looking for me. Yeah, somebody saw that.
Wait, who went down?
He went down. Oh, snap, on the run. There's one more watcher, a guy, and the corruptor. I don't think I can do anything about the corruptor from here. Okay, so that guy's coming out, so I am gonna kill him. Is that a dude? Yeah, there's a cultist down there. Oh, I can't see him from over here.
What if have they been uncovering here?
Goodbye.
Fire! I need a clock!
And then there's one more dude over there. I think that's the Watcher, so if I'm just being quick.
Getting soaked from melted snow.
Oh, rope clean of frost black chomping up hard ground.
So the Corruptor is interested, and I hear something else as well. I don't know where those voices are coming from.
Goodbye, sweet prince.
There we go. So the only thing actively searching for me right now is the Corruptor. I don't see those other guys, though. The ones I just heard talking. Just litter the place with blast traps and then...
More than equipped to take you on.
Okay, he blew up. Yeah, there he goes again. Blowing up pretty much everything. And now the boom! I was in a pit for a second, but yeah, Corruptor down. I think that's pretty much it. I even got a Corruptor heart there. Didn't think I had one of those yet. And that's all the enemies, I think. Which makes this really interesting. I can't pick those back up again. Don't know how he avoided that one as well. But hey, let's continue on. Health potions, I do like those. I'm gonna need to craft a few more arrows here. There we go. Let's continue in here. That was a double precision arrow for a rat. There we go. Now what? Okay, I can climb up here. What is that noise? I think they're reviving a Deathbringer. I've been saying that a lot this episode, but I think they're reviving a Deathbringer. Ooh, what's that? More loot. Ooh, another ancient vessel. Oh, that completed. We completed one of the sets, by the way. So, Sterling Amalkite, Odyssey, Jomei, and the Thunderheads. Interesting nonetheless. What is this going to be? I'm just going slowly because I don't want to get ambushed by anything. Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm running.
Another explosion.
Was that an explosion or was that something walking around? Oh, this is gonna hurt, isn't it? Yeah, I think it's something walking around. Oh dear God.
And fire!
Okay.
All weapons operation. Time to get it moving and be quick about it.
Kill the cultists and the Deathbringer. Jesus Christ.
Has to be one of the Deathbringers Olin talked about. Fitting name. I'll never get into that tower. Unless I destroy that thing first.
Oh, this is gonna be... Stab? Let's mark everything here. Okay. So there's a few guys strewn around here. So if I kill those guys first... I should be fine.
Focus.
So he's down.
Hunt's over. Fight's on.
Oh shit. That thing is moving. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Why does it have death already? Is it dead already? That was easy. Okay then. Deathbringer. That was ridiculously easy. And then the Eclipse officer who's also dead. What the hell? That was way easier than I expected it to be. Because he has a lot of weak points. Which you can all exploit. I know it was at half health already as well, but even so, thought it was going to be a lot harder than it was. What's going on? What do I need to do here? Okay then. Have you only now noticed that something was going on? Because now you're dead.
Did it.
I think I already looted the officer, but there we go. Eclipse focus.
Let's see what you have to say.
Here we go. More information. Ow. My eyes.
What? What is this?
The entity lives. Unacceptable. Unacceptable. Unacceptable.
So we knew they were talking to Hades, and Hades is probably a computer program. The entity lives. They're talking about us, aren't they?
What is that? Hades? Hey! Mysterious stranger, did you see that? No answer, huh? Figures.
Mysterious stranger.
Things just keep getting stranger. I need to find a way inside the tower.
Yes, indeed. Which tower? Is this the tower you're talking about, by the way? Because I don't really see a tower. I'm quickly gonna check the map, by the way. Because I know there should be another vessel over there. Should be another vessel pretty close, but I'm not going to see that right now. So, let's head into the tower. I am scared. Hello?
It's tight, but I can squeeze through.
Squeeze through. Cutscene. Oh, this looks like another vault. Like the one in Mother's... womb?
Hold for identiscan.
One of these again.
But this one won't be corrupted, maybe. Hello? Anybody home?
Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. Please step inside.
Wow, that was impressive. Hello? Well, let's go inside then, I suppose. Oh god, why did the music stop? Okay. Thought something was gonna grab us or something. Okay, this looks familiar. Fado Automated Solutions. Search for information
Fado
about...
Fado, you are 355,510 days overdue for your meeting with Mr. Fair. Please proceed to the 35th floor.
Wait. 350,000? That's hundreds of years ago. What's going on?
Good question, Aloy. Don't think we're gonna get those answers immediately, but don't think I need to... Ooh. Don't think I need to sneak. Okay. Going down. It's a weird way to going down a ladder, Aloy. Okay. The final direction I started looking towards. Is there stuff I can access here? The marker points me in that direction, but I do want to explore a bit. Now that we're in here. Anything in here? Looks like telephones. Call center of some sort. And then B. Nope, okay. Let's head over there. It's been a while since we've seen one of those. Okay. Maybe... Looks like a research lab of some sort. Thank you for all that. And then this.
The protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, quantum encryption, black quartz stuff, way beyond military grade. That's what you demanded. So that's what we delivered.
You don't code something you can't crack. All we need is a backdoor. Upload the latest service pack update and the problem goes away.
You specifically forbade us from leaving anything resembling a backdoor in code. Every protocol to Black Quartz standard. Your words. Look, if you need me to fudge some projections, it's nothing we haven't done before.
I don't need fudged projections. I need a way to reassert control over the Hearts Timor Swarm.
I don't know what to tell you, Ted. You're asking the impossible.
So, codes. They needed codes of some kind to control the machines.
The machines. Yeah, the machines they themselves made. Because this is Faro Automated Machinery, so. They probably created the corruptors. And I assume the Eclipse found the activation codes in these buildings then? Okay. Seems like that's it for this room. Can't really see anything else. Okay. Continuing on. Through the ruins. I love how these technological ruins are mixed with caves of some sort. But if everything was flooded, that might as well prove why everything looks like this. Because it was probably flooded and then iced over. How far does this go? Okay. Nothing around here, but maybe something else interesting around here. A lot of supplies, which is always handy. But what else can we find around here? Nope, doesn't look like it. So let's get back outside.
A Deathbringer. Or a statue of one, anyway. A machine built to kill. And they honored it?
Welcome to Faro Automated Solutions, where all the problems of tomorrow are being solved today. With over 25,000 human employees based in nations and corporate holdings across the globe, Faro leads the world in every sector of self-sustaining, fully automated technology. From revolutionary consumer products close to home, like the Faro Focus, to the dynamic chariot line of peacekeeping robots halting bloodshed in conflict zones across the globe, Faro remains committed to making the future smarter, brighter, safer, and always surprising. Faro Automated Solutions. For every problem of life, a smart solution.
So they made the Focus. 25,000 people? That's bigger than a tribe. So they made machines and devices. I guess those things were common in their world.
Because that's why I was wondering when the introduction started that symbol for Faro looked familiar. And it does indeed look a bit like a Focus. So they made a Focus and the chariot line of defense machinery. So the the Deathbringers and Corruptors. Can we, though? Standard holographic projection device embedded in a molded plastic pedestal. Okay. Touch.
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions.
Okay, okay, yeah, okay. Never mind. Thank you. Yeah, I get it. So that's why you wanted to activate that. And then there's another audio device here. Reception log. It's a text-based. 9:54 a.m. Field Commandant Deng of the Indo-Malay Agricultural Combine arrived with his delegation. Refreshments to be served before their 10:15 a.m. sales presentation on the chariot line. Per instructions, food will be vegetarian only. And then, about 10 minutes later, Sander Agnew, Vice President of Territorial Integrity from Fresh Grounds Coffee Global, arrived with his entourage. Refreshments to be served before their 10:30 a.m. sales presentation of this chariot line. Per instructions, we'll use Fresh Grounds Tacoma blend, no artificial creamers. And then 5 minutes later, so that happened, called security and janitorial to clean up the coffee that was spilled. Actually, more like thrown. It wasn't aware that the Indo-Malay Combine grows coffee beans, and that Fresh Grounds acquisition team has tried to take their fields by force repeatedly. I think Commandant Dane had Agnew by the hair for a second there. Who schedules these things? I'm going to drop a line to sales. This can't happen again. So there was a lot of inter-company problems in fighting in these global corporations, and that apparently was triggered by even small things such as the wrong coffee. Jesus, this is getting more and more interesting.
What were they doing here?
It was a corporation. A group of people, not unlike a tribe. And they made machines.
Yeah, go on.
I've uploaded some data files to your focus. They'll help you understand.
Okay, so let's check those out. Elizabeth Sobeck is an American scientist, roboticist, and engineer, widely regarded as one of the greatest minds of the 21st century. Born and raised outside Carson City, Nevada, she enrolled at Stanford University at age 13, earning a BS in experimental physics and computer science at age 16. She completed her PhD in robotics and artificial intelligence design at Carnegie Mellon University in 2014, and joined Faro Automated Solutions as a junior scientist the same year, rising quickly to chief scientist at the age of 22. Over the next 8 years, her green robot designs played a vital role in realizing the environmental cleanup and detoxification efforts of the clawback decade, propelling FAS to the forefront of its field. In 2048, she suddenly resigned from FAS, protesting the company's pivot to automated military technologies. In 2049, she founded Miriam Technologies, a firm devoted to life-positive robotics and other technologies. Miriam has since become one of the world's largest suppliers of green robots, winning numerous awards and accolades, including the 2053 Nobel Prize for Physics and 2056 Rachel Carson Award for Environmental Progress. She made green robots, and the design of most of the robotic animals we're seeing kinda looks like they should be green robots, because they're recycling, like the scrappers, they recycle technological parts they find. The watchers keep an eye out for the rest of the robots. They seem like they are based in a sort of ecosystem. So I'm wondering if Elizabeth Sobeck is the one that created the machines we're seeing, and that Paro started creating the darker versions, the Corruptor and Deathbringers that we find. And that's the reason why she wanted to go away from Faro and started her own company. That is my assumption at the moment, but I don't know. So Ted Faro, Theodore Faro, is an American entrepreneur and business magnate. He is the founder of Faro Automated Solutions, or FAS, the largest corporation of all time, the world's wealthiest individual, and the first ever trillionaire. Born and raised in Salt Lake City, Utah, he enrolled at the University of California, Los Angeles, where he studied business for 2 years before dropping out in 2033 to start FAS. Though it struggled at first, the company broke through at the end of the troubled 2030s with its popular line of personal servitors and bodyguard bolts. and exploded when its famous line of green robots led the race to solve the climate crisis during the 2040s clawback. At the end of that decade, FAS opened a military defense branch, dominating the world market for automated military platforms by 2053. The success of FAS has made Mr. Faro the world's best-known businessman, one of its most sought-after speakers and a major voice in politics, culture, and international affairs. Then FAS itself is an American multinational corporate entity that produces robots for all walks of life, though its core business consists of military and defense contracts. As of 2063, FAS has ranked number one among the Fortune 5 by gross revenue and profit for 10 years in a row, a world record. Founded in 2033 by Theodore Ted Faro, an entrepreneur from Salt Lake City, the company developed several promising robot prototypes in its early years but failed to break into markets dominated by 10 then-industry giants like General Synthetics and ReCorp. This changed in 2038 with the debut of Alfred line of levitating personal servitors, which generated exceptional sales, lifting the company into the Fortune 50 for the first time. Profits tripled in the 2040s as the company's environmental efforts, led by famed engineer Elizabeth Sobeck, catapulted FAS to the head of that sector. In 2049, in the wake of successful green and climate cleanup efforts around the globe, worldwide approval ratings of FAS exceeded 90%, and founder Ted Faro was hailed across media and social networks as the man who saved the world. Yet it was the emergence of FAS as a military contractor in the late 2040s that cemented its status as the world's wealthiest corporation, with a record market capitalization of over $23 trillion. By 2055, FAS controlled 61% of the market share for automated military platforms, holding contracts with 353 nations, transgovernmental organizations, and corporate entities. Today, its holdings exceed the second largest corporation, FB Mobihall Global, by 321%, so four times the amount of profit. Wow. And then we have definition of corporation. We're going to read that. And then the reception log. Okay. Does Aloy learn more about that now? I don't feel like she does. I almost feel like I want to stop now, but I want to keep going as well. Just because I'm too curious about all of this. There's another room over here. More offices, it seems, and there's something at the end here, so let's listen to that.
Now, I know this must seem like a bizarre change in direction. I mean, we're Faro Automated Solutions, right? Number one robotics firm in the world. Why would we clear our production slate to fabricate human-operated vehicles and weapon systems, the relics of the past? All I can say at this juncture is, trust me, we will be exploiting a massive, growth opportunity by retooling and reallocating capacity according to my plan. So I will need revised projections of mass fabrication velocity across every pipeline within 36 hours.
So they were making machines, then they stopped to make other kinds of weapons? Why?
Yeah, why indeed? Why would they move away from the automated defenses? Because that just means you're gonna be spending more human lives to fix everything. This distance meter is still going up, by the way, instead of going down. Hello? Anything here? Another supply crate.
The air. There's no smell to it. Not even old death. Nothing natural.
What is that noise? Okay. The marker points us in that direction, but what is here? Because this keeps going. Hello? Something at the end here. Might be another power cell, maybe. Why is everything red in here? No power cell? Okay. Nothing else in here? That is interesting. Just this pretty hidden room for one chest. That is weird. Can I? No. Can't exit over here, so I need to go back from the side route. Wait, what? Where did I come from? Ah, over there. That was pretty hidden. Okay, so that means there's a hole over here. Still need to keep moving forward. Complaints from J. Okay, Friedrich. But I could... To reception. Hey reception, if that is your real name, wanna know who scheduled into melee? Oh, so that's about the coffee disaster at the front gate. Right next to Fresh Grounds? Well, that would be me, Senior VP of Sales. Wanna know why? After that little hair-pulling incident, both sides increased their bids by 40%. I'll explain, because your receptionist-level brain probably requires it. These two sides are fighting. And what do we sell? That's right, combat machines. We want them to hate each other, so they will try to fight each other with what? That's right, again, combat machines, which they will pay us a lot of money for. So I'd suggest you go back to serving coffee with a blank smile and let me do my much more complicated job. Thanks a bunch, Mr. Friedkin, to you. Okay, so that guy was an asshole and they were trying to sell war machines to competing companies, so eating from both directions, I feel. Where the hell are we going? Oh, Jesus, Jesus, well, okay, I jumped out of my skin for that one. Holy shit. Okay, then. Thank you. Fuck. That's the reception again. No? This is the elevator, so that leads back up. And I don't need to drop down because we've been there already. Although I could, apparently. Let's take the ladder. There we go. Oh!
I can use that as a ramp to get back up.
Jesus Christ. That was painful. It was a little hole in between the platforms there. Come on, get on there. Okay, and then get back on the ladder. We need to be careful that I don't keep going. There we go. Yeah, okay. Ooh. Where the hell are we going? There's another chest here. I didn't really have a choice where I wanted to go, so yeah, okay, to the right, there we go. Climbing puzzle. Because I can't save at the moment anyway, so I'm just gonna keep going. Hello? So the point is in that direction, but oh, what the hell? What the hell is all of this? So this looks like a boardroom. A room where you get bored. And then this thing. Dexter audio. Text, apparently. From Ted Farrow to Paula Vesala. Paula, recent events have sharpened my perspective, and I think that I, and Fals in general, have been neglecting the spiritual side of things. Not under any specific religious framework, of course, but in a more general sense. As in not giving enough thought to our shared values, hopes, and aspirations for the afterlife. I'd like you to reach out to religious leaders of every stripe with the intention of scheduling a conference soon. Very soon. I'll have more thoughts about the agenda later, but for now let's put out some feelers and see if we can lock something in. Make it a big tent, no cooks, but anyone with a credible audience. Let's go deluxe, make it clear we'll spare no expense. Thanks, Ted. So that's his turnaround, so when he decided to make more man-handled machines. What else is there? There's another supply box here. There should be another power cell in here as well, I presume. Another answering machine. Or notebook. Security log. High priority alert. All non-essential systems have entered hibernation. Full lockdown has been initiated. Due to the increasing frequency of violent protests targeting the campus, the security of FAS employees can no longer be guaranteed. Therefore, we have taken the difficult decision to shutter this facility indefinitely. Staff will be briefed on a block-by-block basis regarding proper procedure for archiving and/or disposal of project-related data and materials. High Second and Crisis Team will then conduct exit review before all areas are locked down. Treat the current lockdown situation as an exercise, but do not attempt to release the hatches or otherwise exit the buildings. A reminder that while HiSec personnel remain committed to employee safety during the current unfortunate events, personnel firearms must be relinquished when presenting for identity scan. Additional public access roads en route to the campus have now been closed to relieve waiting time at the outer security cordons. HiSec reminds all staff that the campus remains off limits to the public. Presented for identity scan and displaying your security badge prominently at all times, for image analytics are both mandatory. And in light of recent acts of terrorism directed at the rapid transit system, HiSec now offers a Big Brother initiative to accompany staff traveling from off-site. Sign-up is required and strongly encouraged. 48 more entries in high priority, additional entries corrupted. Okay, so they were getting attacked more frequently.
People were angry at Faro, at the corporation. They blamed this place for something. Something bad.
This is rather big. What the hell is this place? Anything I can scan? Doesn't look like it. I can activate this. Seems like a holographic meeting room, although there are a lot of offices in here as well. Let's touch one of these. Here we go.
The FSP-5 Kopesh provides a one-size-fits-all solution to main battle force capability. Metamaterial construction delivers unmatched recoil dampening, allowing you to field any weapon package that conforms to your budget needs and conflict resolution profile. Patented biomass conversion systems allow extended emergency operations with minimal environmental impact. Multilinear target processing provides simultaneous real-time threat analysis and legal review for autonomous domestic operations, or control can be slaved to the swarm's neural network for weapons-free force application. Either way, when it's time to call out the big guns, it's time to call Kopesh.
The Deathbringer. So this was the heavy hitter. Main battle force indeed.
It's interesting that they called it... They keep talking about a swarm. Is this something different then?
The ACA-3 scanner combines conventional and information warfare capabilities in one package. Designed for high-speed, all-terrain reconnaissance. It boasts the world's highest survivability rating of any Scout-class autonomous agent. Maybe it's the Scarab's emergency biomass conversion systems that ensure it always makes it back to base, even if fuel supply lines have been interdicted. Or maybe it's the Scarab's ability to slave enemy robots to its own network. Now that's force multiplication. Add a prehensile manipulator arm that can handle a host of functions, from 360-degree less lethal riot management to surgical repairs of allied chariot line models, and you've got the workhorse of any cutting-edge peacekeeping fleet.
The Corruptor. Slave enemy robots to its own network. It sounds like it's talking about how it corrupts machines.
Okay, that is interesting, but why is corruption then a physical thing? It's not just a connection to a network, because it's actually a physical thing that can harm us as well. And the other interesting thing that said is that a Corruptor, so a Scarab, can actually heal a Kopesh. So repair the chariot thingy, the Deathbringer. So that's going to be something to not look forward to. Do I move forward? I think I'm going to have to take a little break, because otherwise this episode is going to keep going. So, when we get back, we're going to continue exploring the Faro Automated Solutions facility. and hopefully get a bit more answers as well, because we've learned a lot already in this episode, but this keeps getting more and more interesting. So if you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again, enormously, for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.